There was a stately grace about these slim Spanish children as they glided about. The boys with their large plumed hats and short fluttering cloaks, the girls holding up the trains of their long brocaded gowns and shielding the sun from their eyes with huge fans of black and silver. But the Infanta was the most graceful of all, and the most tastefully attired, after the somewhat cumbrous fashion of the day. Her robe was of grey satin, the skirt and the wide puffed sleeves heavily embroidered with silver, and the stiff corset studded with rows of fine pearls. Two tiny slippers with big pink rosettes peeped out beneath her dress as she walked. Pink and pearl was her great gauze fan, and in her hair, which like an aureole of faded gold stood out stiffly round her pale little face, she had a beautiful white rose. From a window in the palace, the sad, melancholy king watched them. Behind him stood his brother, Don Pedro of Aragon, whom he hated, and his confessor, the Grand Inquisitor of Granada, sat by his side. Sadder even than usual was the king, for as he looked at the Infanta bowing with childish gravity to the assembling courtiers, or laughing behind her fan at the grim Duchess of Albuquerque, who always accompanied her, he thought of the young queen, her mother, who but a short time before, so it seemed to him, had come from the gay country of France and had withered away in the sombre splendour of the Spanish court, dying just 6 months after the birth of her child, and before she had seen the almonds blossom twice in the orchard, or plucked the second year's fruit from the old gnarled fig tree that stood in the centre of the now grass-grown courtyard.